Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. So many of you have requested me for communication skills topic, so I'm doing it now. Thank you, and let's get it started. So why do we need communication skills? Why is it important for us to learn or acquire knowledge upon communication skills? So only one thing is today in demand is communication skills, because wherever you go for an interview, you go for any kind of work or business or everywhere, maybe in public or private, or you have a social gathering, wherever you go, in any part of your life, you need communication skills, because communication is nothing but the exchange of ideas or facts or opinions, or I can say emotions, by two or more people or among two or more people. So for example, you are with your family members, or you go out with your friends, or you are in a public place, or in a you are attending a meeting or a party, or wherever you go. So maybe you are in the office. So wherever you go, in any part of your life, you go and meet some people, more than one. So you need a communication barrier, or communication. That is nothing but a exchange of information happens. Like, you talk to the other person understands what you are saying. So that is called communication. When the other person understands what you are saying, is nothing but the effective way of communication. Okay, so hope you understood what communication is. That is, it's a two-way process. It's a two-way process where two persons exchange the information in a bidirectional way. So it's a two-way process, right? So in order to make the other person understand, one person or the first person should talk in a clear way, and also he should be doing the small talk so that the other can understand it in a clear way. So here there can also be facial expressions as well. So when you are communicating, so the other person can easily understand your facial expressions as well. For example, you're making some gestures. So that is also a part of communication, right? So before, making, faces or doing some gestures, we have to be more precise, or have to understand that the other person might understand our gestures. So we should be very much careful before, doing any kind of facial expressions, because it might hurt or shows disrespect to the other person. So why do we need this communication? As we have told that regard that the other person can understand it very well. Apart from this, for example, the person 1 or 2 or A is talking to a person B. So if a person A is communicating with person B, if he is unable to talk in a proper way, or he is unable to paraphrase the sentences properly, then the person B might misunderstand the person A. So this is one of the benefits of communication, right? So the other thing is, it builds a healthy relationship. So if a person B is also communicating properly with a person A, then a healthy relationship would be built, right? Because he understands what he is saying, and he understands what he is saying, he or she, either ways. So that is, expressing oneself or expressing yourself is nothing but an effective way of communication. right? So how can you improve? Now, how can you improve the effective communication? So you can improve by doing a small talk first. Small talk in the sense, you talk in small sentences, use small phrases. That is words which are easily understood. Alright. So the second thing is telling facts. Facts. So you have to talk. For example, you are in a social gathering. So you start to you meet a new person or who you know him or you don't know. For example, you meet a new person, so you start talking to him with a small conversation. Then you try telling facts about it, because there would be some topic you would be starting it, right? Because if a person talks to another, so whenever we meet another person, we try to talk with them and we try to talk about anything that, you know, which is similar or which is, we can just have a small talk, that is called. So you can tell the facts. So for this, you discuss about the discuss your background. Discuss your background. You discuss the interests and skills. So whenever you are talking to others, you also discuss about your background, your interests, because you try to introduce yourself so that the other person knows about you, so that he can have a good impression about you and start building a good a friendly relation. So this is everybody does, almost everyone. So this you have to start doing it in English language, which is a language which is understood by the other person. So you can talk about your background, your interests and skills. So the skills what you have, what the things what you are interested in, right? So then you have to express your ideas about, as you are doing a small talk about a topic, so you have to express the ideas. Third is expressing ideas. So let others know what you're thinking about that particular topic or that particular skill, right? So also share the feelings or thoughts about that skill, and try to be honest as well. Finally, whenever you build a conversation between you and the other person, that is a conversation. So once a conversation has started and you share the thoughts, and also try to be completely honest, because honesty leads to a good friendship, and it leads to a good relationship as well. So it is must. So this is the effective way of communicating, and how you improve your communication. So these all things will lead to a good environment or a good friendliness, and other person would think that you are the best person, and it will last for a long time. That is what is the communication is. Will start to teach you. So, and what are the things we should stop while you're communicating with others is, you should not be talking too much, and you should not be like in a position that you're not giving a chance to the other person to speak. So that is, you should talk and you should let others talk too. So whenever you're saying something, if the other person, you have to look at him, you have to understand his facial expression. If ever, if at all he wants to say something, let him speak. So that is a better way, so that the other person won't think otherwise about you. So that, and you have to, that is also called, like, you know, you have to give time to express, right? So maybe yourself or others have to give time to express themselves. So you should be, you should not be critical or judgmental. Whenever you're talking or speaking about some topic or with others, among others, you should not be judgmental. And you should not be like continuously laughing at someone or laughing about something. You should not be like that. Or it humiliates someone. So it should not be like that. So these are the things we should avoid. Also, we should stop arguing with them or contradicting with the speaker or with the other person. And we should not be disrespectful with others. So these all things would, break the trust and also break the friendliness among others. So these are the things which we have to take care before talking to others. So this is whenever you're communicating with others, right? So apart from this, so how we should keep our words very simpler, in simpler words, is you have to think before you say. You have to think before what you're saying. So all that is also called as always think ahead about what you are going to say. And use simple words and phrases, as I said earlier, that should be understood by everybody. And increase your knowledge on all the subjects you are required to speak. And speak clearly and audibly. That should be audible to the others. I mean, especially the listeners. And you should be an active listener as well. Because they might ask something or ask some questions. And you should be in a position to answer them. So that you have to listen to them. So be an active listener on both the sides. That is both the speaker as well as the listeners. In case of interruption, always do a little recap of what has been already said. For example, anybody poses you a question, or there is in between a conversation, if somebody asks you something or discuss something, then try to again do a little recap or about what has been already said. So while listening, always make notes of important points. And always ask for clarification if you have failed to grasp others' point. So these are the things about the effective communication. And in this communication, there can be... I will show you just a moment. Let me wipe this off. I say, just writing a shortcut. This can be verbal communication, non-verbal, and visual. And these verbal can be divided into many other types. non-verbal as well. So these are the main three C's or three types of communications. Like, you know, wherever you may be into business or interpersonal communication or anything you do. So here, in this verbal, it's all about what we say. It can be verbal in the sense, it can be written, spoken. And the words we choose can make a big difference to whether other people understand us or not. So the written communication is nothing but email, or you're writing a letter to somebody, or posting a letter, or you're writing a business email. These comes under written. Spoken in the sense you have a face-to-face or you have a telephonic. Right? That's the mark. So in non-verbal as well, we can say this includes the facial expressions, this includes the body language, this includes gestures, this includes signals and tone of voice and appearance. Okay, so as this includes facial expressions, the way we express the feelings on our face, the body language, how we talk, how we walk, how we, you know, do the signs, you know, how we sit. So that is body language. The appearance, the way we dress. So gestures is nothing but we do the body sign. That's a signing language. Gestures like we move our eyebrows, we try to move our, face around. So just, you know, making faces. It's simple. In simpler words, it's called making faces. And then, apart from this, whenever you do a verbal as well as non-verbal communication, make sure you build a rapport with the person you are having a conversation with. So building a rapport increases the relationship. It improves the relations with the business, wherever you deal with the personally or professionally. And this visual communication is nothing but presentation. This is presentation skills. Like, you know, you try to exhibit yourself in a PPT, and then you project it to your managers, or, you know, you project it to a business dealer, like that. So it gives a good information about the topic or the one which you're discussing about. So this is what is about the verbal communication and non-verbal. So in our next class, we'll discuss about how to write effective emails, that is a business emails, and also how to do a good telephonic and face-to-face conversation as well. Hope this video is useful to you all. So apart from this, also I would like to tell you that you can improve your communication skills by talking to the people often. So, like, you know, you try to speak with the people who know the language better. So just try to communicate with them, practice. I try to have a conversation always, and if you get a time, then try writing some notes on it, like essay or something else. Write about a topic, like a content writers, they just write upon some topics. So they keep practicing it. That's how they become content writers. So now that is huge in demand, so because now content writer are getting more paid nowadays. So even you can become the one by just practicing how to write, and by reading novels or newspapers or magazines or, you know, any book. You have e-books today, so you can, it's easy. It's very easy to, read any kind of books, because they are easily available now in online. So this is a way to improve your communication and never give up. So this is the only one funda I can say. You have to never give up. So you have to keep on moving and keep on practicing, keep on talking, to have a small talk with others, then keep on being confident about yourself. That is most important, and this will build a self-confidence within yourself, and also this gives a good output as well. There will be a good result on whenever you talk to others. So hope this video is useful, and for any questions you can comment in the comment section. And thank you all for watching this video. If you want more videos from me, then please like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you everyone. Bye bye.